everyone, and welcome to my first unboxing video ever on my channel. We're going to be unboxing today the DMX controller with 240 scenes and 192 channels. It also came with an LED gooseneck. We're going to be doing this Ashen style today, so you're only going to see my hands just because this box is so large. Just a short description of what's inside the box. You can see here there's three different controllers. I have the one that has the 16 sliders on it, this one that I'm pointing at. Now, from what I understand, this is definitely made in China, but also it comes under a whole bunch of different names to the US, and so they're all the same if you find this particular style. And there's apparently three styles. I got mine for about $60. I got it on eBay. And so yeah, let's get started. Handy dandy knife. Now, I've been waiting all day to open this, and I'm super excited to finally get a look at it. Just opening up right now, I can already see that the LED gooseneck has kind of come out of its packaging, but that's cool. Let's set this off to the side. It's pretty nice size. I didn't know quite what to expect with it. When I was looking over the box did have a few dents and dings on it, but I'm hoping that didn't affect anything inside. I have looked this over, and I've actually gotten the instructions from the company in China. I'm going to set the box off to the side. Now, you can see here, here's the actual controller. Comes nicely packaged. Wow, they just got some 8.5 by 11 paper here and just printed out the instructions, eh? So yeah, it's nicely packaged. It's looking pretty good. Just take these foam things off the sides. Throw those back in the box over here. Now I guess we're going to take the plastic off and take a look at this bugger. It wasn't too difficult to open. It shipped from California, which company said they have things in California. So you can see here now, let me get the thing out of the way. Also, it came with this power adapter. Just doesn't feel too heavy. It's not, it's Chinese power adapter. What are you going to do? The sliders feel pretty nice. They don't feel wobbly or anything. The buttons are a little bit loose, might say. They're not going to pull out, but they do push. I would hope. So yeah, what are we looking at here? We're looking at 16 sliders, and the way, ooh, this one looks a little kerflugled, bent, I mean. But yeah, we have 16 sliders, and the way it works is each of these sliders controls a channel. So each channel is up here, so channel 1 through 16. And then what you do is they call it the scanner. And there's scanners 1 through 12. And basically what that it means is you have 16 times 12, which gets you your 192 channels, or something along those lines. There's this one little bent one here, but it doesn't seem to be broken, at least. So basically what you would do is you would press scene 1, and that would activate channels 1 through 16. And that means you would get your light, and you would set channel 1 on your light, and that would, and that's just in case you have a 16 channel light. And also, you also have your scenes on here, which are basically you set you preset what lighting conditions you want, and that's the scene. Now, there's also chases on here, right here where I'm pointing to a chase. The chase is basically a set of scenes which you program. Up here is the speed and fade timer, right here. And this, it just, the speed means how long it takes to go between chases or scenes, and the fade is how quickly it fades between chases. So you can do a lot with this kind of thing. I do have to say it's very weighty. Feels pretty well constructed except for these little wobbly buttons. What are you gonna get for $60 from China? Now on the back, you're gonna be able to see this here. Let's get a little closer to the camera. You have your power button. You have the plug-in, which is the USB for your lamp, your power, and you have a DMX out, which is both male and female, which is it's pretty cool actually that you have an out, which is male and female. Then you have a MIDI. I don't know too much about the MIDI. I guess we'll move on to the USB LED lamp. I guess I'm gonna try and plug this into my computer later. It's a pretty nice little lamp. It plugs in, in the back here and lights up your board, and looks pretty neat. On the USB lamp guide here, I guess you say, it says light up your notebook anywhere you wish on the plane, period. On the plane, comma, in a meeting, or in bed. Compatible with any notebook or PC, easily plugs into any USB port on notebook or PC. Then on the back here, it just has a user guide. It's rated for an average of 8,000 hours of use. But yeah, I mean, it seems to be pretty good. I'm going to cut now, and we're going to plug this in and see how it works. So guys, I'm back. I set up a few of the lights that I have here, and everything seems to be working just fine. I'm gonna give you a little light show now, just to show you how it works. So first of all, what you want to do is I preset this light here. Can you see that? There we go. I preset this light here to channel 1. And also, I preset this light right here to channel 17. Now, the reason why I did that was because, as you can see right in here, this first scanner controls 1 to 16. And the reason why you can remember that is there's 16 sliders on here, which controls 16 channels for scanner 1. Then scanner 2 controls the next 16 channels, so that's why this one is on 17. Now I'm just going to give you a little light show so you can see that this actually does work. I'm going to turn off the lights. And give you the show. And the reason you see the slight purple light above is because I have some rope lights on, and they're on the same switch that I have all these other lights on. So we're going to go with the can first. Now, the first channel of the can is actually the brightness and flashing. So I have to set this in the middle to get the max brightness, but then we're going to go ahead and show you red, green, and blue, or you can have all of them on, and so forth. And that's the first channel. Now I'm going to go back down here, turn the first one off, and now I'm going to turn the second one on. Now this is the disco ball, and the disco ball, for some reason, oh, do I have it on 17 here? Yeah, I have it on 17, okay. Oh, yeah, it probably didn't reset, so yeah. You kind of have to reset these sliders I found. Just push them up and down when you go to another channel, because they don't quite automatically reset. So anyway, this is the brightness on the first slider. Then the second slider controls the red. You can see it's the magic disco ball, and the second green, third blue. And remember, I have this on channel 17, which is the start of scanner 2. But also, there's not just red, green, and blue. There's also flashing on the next channel. and a motor controlled position. You can see him slightly moving, I can move him faster on the last channel, which would be channel 6. So this is a 6 channel light. Now you can kind of understand why you would have here, let's have a little bit of fun with this. Now you can kind of understand why you would have 16 channels for each scanner. You can kind of understand that because a lot of these lights, at least the more advanced ones, can be up to 16 channels with the pan, the tilt, for moving head ones, but also you have to consider for the pan, the tilt, and each light inside, each LED, not each one, but sections of each LED segment could be on each channel. So that's just a little wrap up of how these lights work. I love my DMX lights. So if you have any questions at all on this particular lighting display, oh, you can see the little gooseneck light thing works too, which is pretty neat. If you have any questions at all, don't hesitate to message me or shoot me a thing on Twitter or Facebook or what have you. Or comment in the make sure to comment below and subscribe to my channel, because I'm going to have lots more stuff coming up. And yeah, have a good night.